Guys, look at my new mug. Yeah. Ooh, that's good. Hello, my beautiful book dragons. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel. If you have not subscribed already, you might want to click that button right there. I do make a little dance every single time someone clicks it, so I'm just saying, you will make me very, very happy. Anyways, today I'm going to be doing my August wrap up. Finally, I thought August was never going to be over, honestly. Okay, so like I said, I'm going to be talking about the books that I read in August, but I want to do something a little bit different this month. I'm going to be talking about them from best to worst. So I've organized them all, and I mean, it's sad for the ones that are at the bottom of the list, but if I'm being honest, I had a couple that I was like not really enjoying, and I'm going to be talking about them right now. So let's get started. Now, just for my own goalkeeping and checking what is it that I'm actually reading or not, I read 6 ebooks, 3 physical books, and 1 audiobook. Now, why am I talking about this? I definitely need to work on my physical copies, number one. Number two, I want to be able to say that I am taking advantage of the subscriptions that I have. So I do make a monthly payment to Scribd and to Kindle Unlimited. So I want to make sure that I'm also using those resources because I am spending money on them. So that's why I kind of want to start just reflecting back, not just the books that I read and what I thought about them, but how is it that I'm reading. All of this makes a total of 10 books, and considering that one of them is The Complete Short Stories of Oscar Wilde, I'm just taking that as one of the books that I read. And it's about, maybe a little bit less than this, it's about this. I think I did pretty well, so. Now, into my goals. The only thing that I was missing is to read a Stephen King book. I'm trying to read every single thing that he's written, and I didn't read anything by him this month, which is probably why it was kind of a crappy month for reading for me. Other than that, I did read at least one classic. I read more, but it's great. I continued one of the stories that I'm reading, and also I read a non-fictional book, so goals are great except for the Stephen King part. So without further ado, let's get into the books that I read. From best to worst, the best book that I read this month was Between the World and Me by Ta-Nehisi Coates. And I just have so much to say about this book, so I'm going to make a whole video for this, just discussing this, because there is so much I got from it that I want to share with you guys as well. So definitely keep an eye for that. But this is a really nice long letter that he wrote for his son, and he talks about racism, growing and living as a black man in the USA. He goes into the death of Prince because he knew him. It's just so much for me to talk about like 30 seconds of this video, so keep an eye for that, because I will be making a blog post that I am working on, and I'm gonna be making a video with just every single thing. The next best thing that I read is The Yellow Wallpaper by Charlotte Perkins Gilman. I do have a complete video on this. It was my best Classic Thursday, which is a new series that I'm starting up on my channel, where I just talk about a new classic, where I just talk about a classic every single Thursday. And last Thursday we discussed The Yellow Wallpaper. In this story, we follow a woman from the Victorian era who's just become a mother, and she's suffering from postpartum psychosis. And in this deeply disturbing short story, we see the consequences of wrongly treating mental illness and not having equality in marriage. A great classic that makes you rethink the difficulty that lots of women suffered back then, and make us reflect how far we've come in treating and perceiving mental illnesses, and how far we still have to go to provide safety to anyone going through anything like this. Next fabulous thing that I read, like I said, was The Complete Short Stories by Oscar Wilde. This is a complete thing with the plays, the stories, all of his essays, writings, letters. But I just finished the short stories this month, and let me tell you, reading every single short story, one after the other, what's the best decision I've made this month. But throughout the stories, you can see all the elements that make Oscar Wilde one of my absolute favorite writers. The way that he criticizes society through simplistic and stupid character expresses great morals like humility, honesty, and goodness, making the story almost feel fable-like. But when you least expect it, he throws in there just a tiny speck of darkness to make you reflect and feel that chill in the back of your neck. That really brings this into the real life and makes you think, how can people do this? How can people think like this? And definitely something that we see a lot in the real world, and it's just nice to have this. And of course, really through Oscar Wilde's eyes, and just another Victorian era kind of realization that we still have to go and work in through a lot of the stuff that he's talking about. So, top notch. The next thing that I read was, I'm holding up my Kindle. I don't know. You cannot even see the book over. I don't know. The next thing is Redhead by the Side of the Road by Anne Tyler. Even though this is my first Anne Tyler read, I could totally see why people get so involved with her books and writing style. In this novel, we follow Mika, a very rigid and organized guy in his early 40s who has everything figured out, kind of, you know. He's cleaning schedule, he's got his own small company, he's got a really rigid exercise routine, etc., that kind of thing. The only thing that he can't quite figure out is the relationship part of it all. His girlfriend seems to be getting evicted, and after being together for years, perhaps wants to move forward with a relationship. A kid appears at his door saying he's his child. And just like that, Mika starts realizing maybe he doesn't have everything down as he thought. And Tyler manages to explore human relationships in so many levels, taking a routinary and boring life of a dull man and makes you invested and makes you want to keep reading the book. So a book that I really enjoyed reading this month, super interesting. A lot of people might find it really boring because it's a fiction book, but it reads as a non-fiction book. We're following a really boring character. I feel like what really keeps you going through this read is the exploration of the relationships of the character with other people. And also for me, I tend to be that rigid as well, so I could relate a little bit with the character as well, which I really enjoyed. The next thing is There'll Be Peace When You Are Done by Lynn S. Sebernis, another book that deserves its own video here on my channel. This is a great collection of letters from cast and fans of the TV show Supernatural, and I think it's a must-have to anyone that is just trying to cope with the ending of the show. I mean, after 15 years of having a great run, the show is ending, and these beautiful letters really help you understand that the fandom is going to still be there. So I will totally recommend a read if you are a fan of the TV show. Another fabulous book and story that I am following, The Hostel Hospital by Lemony Snicket, the 8th book in a series of unfortunate events. This installment of the series is one of my favorite, or maybe even my favorite so far in the series. We continue to follow the Baudelaire brothers and the misfortune that follows them everywhere they go after their parents die in a mysterious fire. We find new clues into the secret organization of BFD, and honestly, I felt like the kids really grew and matured in this one, especially Sonny, the youngest of the Baudelaires, and I really am enjoying Lemony Snicket writing style. It's just so unique, mysterious, funny, but at the same time sarcastic, bringing the kids being the smart ones and the adults being the stupid ones. Let's just put it that way. So really enjoying this series. Maurice by Ian Foster is the one that's making the next book in my list. It's a classic, written in 1930, but was published after Foster died in 1921 because he didn't want to be persecuted for writing about same-sex love. We follow Maurice Hall from adolescence and beyond while he's trying to figure out his sexuality, and he struggles with it as well. Of course, at the time, it's going to be a little bit more difficult for him to just express his love for men and not women, so we follow through that struggle. I'm going to be honest why this is so far down in my list. It took me a while to get into the writing style, and I really found that the story was going so slowly. I feel like 50% of the book was not even about him saying that he was gay. Like, his sexuality came like openly about 50% of the book, and it just went so slowly. So it took me, I think, a couple of months to complete this one. Let's move on to the next book. I read Goddess of the Hunt by Shelby Aileen. This is a collection of small poems. Since I read Milk and Honey, I've been reading more of these little collections, trying to find something similar to it. With this one, it's the same kind of vibes, but written from Artemis, the goddess of the hunt. So we see through her eyes the way that she thinks about love, relationships, humans, etc. It was nice. I'm gonna give you a little peek to see if you like the writing style and the poems. I believe one villain can bring it all down, or one hero can put it all back together, then you have not been paying attention. He's got a lot of these nice reflective poems, like all of these collections, but I don't know if this is one of my favorite ones. I've definitely found a better shorts collection of poems. Sadly, I mean, I still enjoy it. I still got a couple that I really liked, but for the most part, I felt like because we were talking about the Goddess of the Hunt and whatever, it was not completely relevant into my life. Sadly, coming up almost last, Down Among the Sticks and Bones by Shannon McQuire. I was really enjoying the first book. This is the second book in the Wayward Children series, and I sadly didn't enjoy this one as much as I enjoyed the first one. I'm even questioning if I want to continue on with the series, or maybe it is just not for me. In this one, we follow the journey of Jack and Jill, and we follow them from the moment that they found their door, and because we already read what happens to them in the first one, we already know what's going to happen in this book. So that made me feel a little bit bored and took away the sense of adventure out of the book. And then, sadly, coming up at last, this is the worst book I read this month, With the Fire on High by Elizabeth Acevedo. I really had big hopes for this one after reading the Poetics and loving it. But sadly, I really don't have a lot of good things to say about this one. We follow Emoni through her fascinating life in high school, and by fascinating I mean completely boring. This really read like a YA, and I was not there for it. You know, it started strong, it started great. What I think makes Acevedo's books really great is the relationships and the way the characters interact with each other. We didn't have a lot of that. It just completely turned into a YA romance book. I was not there for that. So I sadly couldn't enjoy this one as much as I enjoyed The Poet X. So that would be it for this video. Those are the 10 books that I read this month. How did your reading month of August went? I would like to know. So please let me know down below if you agree or disagree with anything that I said on the books that I just talked about as well. And please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you have not already. And I will see you beautiful book dragons on my next video. Bye!
Remember when you saw me in a club, didn't show me any love? You was too busy popping by.